With COVID cases surging and the state ordering a pullback, many businesses are being forced to shut down again. And some in Monterey are reporting that police are showing up at their doorsteps. Some say the tactic is heavy-handed, but police say it's all about education. When Harmony Drew learned that she would have to shut down her salon again, she began that process immediately. And so she was surprised when the police showed up.
I mean, at first I thought that somebody called the cops on me for being in my business doing what I need to do.
And Monterey police did confirm to us that after the rollback orders came down from the state earlier this week, they did conduct a series of what they're calling educational visits to salons, barbershops, gyms, etc. They say they were merely educating, letting those businesses know that they had to shut down again. But the owner of Citizen Hair here on Foam Street says simple email would have accomplished the same thing without the intimidation factor.
I mean, I think that a better tactic would be to let businesses know. I mean, the county knows we're here, the state knows we're here, we pay taxes, they have our phone numbers, our emails. So why can't they give us a little notice? They could have given us all that educational information prior.
In addition to those educational visits, the state health department also announced that so-called state strike teams are also in Monterey County. Essentially, they're compliance officers targeting businesses that are regulated by the state, making sure that those businesses are following the rules. Monterey police say they're not working with the strike teams, and instead, they're funneling all their complaints to the DA's office.
Since the new closure restrictions came down, we have definitely seen an increase in the number of complaints, and so we are attempting to respond to those complaints as quickly as we can. I know other agencies as well, code enforcement and other local law enforcement agencies, are also seeing increases in complaints.
Businesses do say that all of this, from police visits to strike teams, ups the anxiety level for business owners already stretched to the limit.
I feel like there's a collective anxiety going on in the world that we're all feeling, and to localize it is just intensifying all of that for all of us.
And as for the so-called state strike teams, they are operating separately from local authorities, and they have their own enforcement authority, which often includes revoking licenses. Both state and local authorities say the goal here is to get businesses to comply and keep people safe.